The community-owned school is made up of temporary structures made from timber of cats. All the school structures are incomplete without doors and windows. Paper and cotton materials have been fixed in window spaces to obscure learners from what is outside their classroom environment. The heavy rains have for long destroyed the school's scholastic materials and other property, according to Angeline Katureve, the school's head teacher.
We don't have enough classrooms. The classrooms we have are the same permanent. They need permanent classrooms. We don't have paper to water. The paper to water is very expensive, but at least we have the roof. We have the iron sheets which we got from the Pearl Africa, so if we got a rain harvest container, like a tank.
Katureve says that they lack enough scholastic materials and furniture. The entire school population depends on temporarily built pit latrine.
These same permanent things, the bags from trees called coco, they are the ones we are using as chairs. We don't have chairs, we don't have tables, we don't have any school furniture. Even the scholastic materials, we don't have them. And the problems are still many. We don't have enough latrines. The number of children are increasing. This school is in a rural community, and parents need education.
Godfrey Mutegechi, a parent, says putting up a school was a collective effort by the community members to shorten the distance from which those children were traveling to access education.
When the school is started, it lacks a lot. It is still under construction. We need more support from the government. Of course, we need textbooks, we need chairs that will help our children move on and get better education.
Leonard Were, a general secretary of PAL Bikers Uganda, explains how they got to learn about the plight of the learners at Hope Parents School. Were says after assessing the situation, they started a fundraising drive to support the school.
Children do not have places of convenience. They have temporary structures just to present privacy, but they do not have permanent structures. So we think if there are partners out there who can come and support in constructing permanent sanitation facilities, pit latrines, because here water is not readily available, it would be very welcome.
However, although the PAL Bikers Africa have supported the roofing of the school, a lot more support is needed to create a conducive learning environment for the students.
Children do not have water, and we have discussed with their management and actually agreed that as a temporary measure, it would be nice to have a water harvesting tank.
Nesta Basemera says that many more other community schools in the district are struggling to operate and has called on for intervention from the government and other stakeholders to improve the learning conditions of students in the district.
We are calling upon everybody else, the partners in development, the government, to partner with us to provide quality education in the Bunyangabu district.
Report by Roger Sunday for the news.